What is going on? This is a little bit of a utility video. We're here with my portable laptop computer that I use for a very specific purpose, usually if I'm on vacation or on the go. But one of the main things that I like to do with it is to edit my samples that I capture from outdoors. So in this video, we're just going to go about my process of how I transfer samples from my computer to my desired sampler. In this case, it's the EMU ESI 4000. And before we get started, I'd just like to let you know that episode 50 of the Samplers Podcast is live right now, covering the topic of starting a music YouTube channel. If you've ever tried to start a YouTube channel or have been thinking about it, this is the podcast for you as I go over 10 tips that I've learned over the years to help you start off the right way. I've been on YouTube for 10 plus years now, and I've seen a lot of people come and go. And there's a reason for it. So after you're done with this video, check out the Samplers Podcast episode 50, info in the description box below. Now, I'm in the process of just capturing new sounds. I've been going on kind of a binge lately, and I just wanted to share with you how I sort of get these samples where I want them to go. So initially what I do is I go around with my Zoom recorder outside and just capture anything that catches my ears. It doesn't have to be anything specific, just something that I feel I can use later on, yeah? So once I record them, and I like to record at the highest resolution possible, and on this particular Zoom recorder, it is 96 kilohertz at 24-bit, just so I can capture a nice, tight stereo field, as high fidelity as I can get. Once those are captured, I transfer them to this laptop, which is running a copy of an audio editor called SoundForge. Now, you can use any audio editor you want. SoundForge Studio here costs about 60 bucks. It's cheap, but it does everything I need to do to kind of get those sounds edited to little micro samples, like little shots that sound kind of percussive or melodic, anything like that, sometimes loops, and I organize them into a group of sounds that I like. So as you can see here, I have about 29 sounds in total, all edited, ready to go into the sampler. And from there, I essentially just connect a portable audio interface, which is the Focusrite Scarlett 2i2 over there. It's always good, I found, to really just have a secondary audio interface from your main one, something portable that you could just boot around when you're ready to go. And this one has served more than I can ever ask from it over the years. So anyway, from there, I go straight out of the audio interface, sometimes through a mixer, but eventually end up into the sampler. Again, we're using the ESI 4000 by EMU. And I can almost hear some disgruntled person say something like,
"Well, actually, you could do this a lot easier using a sample dump. And besides, you've recorded the samples at 96 kilohertz and the ESI only samples at 44.1. Thought you'd already know that, Daydream. Huh."
And that is actually true. What is also true is that I just enjoy sampling. I like the idea of moving sound through the analog domain and capturing it again in another digital environment. I simply enjoy the act of sampling. I wouldn't be using all these old samplers simply for their looks. And in addition to that, I enjoy creating a sort of sound palette for the samples that I sample. So I've started at 96 kilohertz, that's true. And I've eroded it down to 16-bit 44.1. The ESI 4000 I chose for a specific reason because it has a certain color that I like. So I'm trying to build a vibe for the sound, something that I can have a specific purpose for later on. So everything kind of has a reason for doing things, and your method could be different as long as it's conducive to the way you work, right? So from here, I usually sit down for about an hour and just have a really good session of just sampling. One by one, I'll play each of the sounds individually through the sound card into the ESI, capture them, truncate them, normalize them, make sure everything's good, and I'll end up with some sort of kit. From there, in the ESI, I'll set up the way that I want each to play, whether I want them to play monophonically, polyphonically, filter them, get the envelope straight, get everything that I would like, modulation sources, the whole entire deal. And then I'll simply save it. And this is the way that I found that I've worked best with rack mount samplers, because when I turn them on, I don't want to do any of what I'm speaking about right now when it's time to go. I just want the sounds ready. And rack mount samplers, in my view, are amazing for that. The ESI 4000 has an internal zip disk, has tons of RAM, at least for my purposes. And so when I turn it on and I load up this kit, it's ready to go. Whereas with samplers like the InSonic EPS 16 Plus, which I am using today to actually play back the samples and test them as I sample, you can actually start from scratch and go really quickly because your entire interface is right there. You don't have to kind of reach and connect and do all type of stuff. You have a whole working environment ready to go because it has an onboard keyboard. Everything's kind of just right there. You know what I mean? And this is pretty much the way I work with my sounds. You'll hear that on the new album, History Never Gets Old, releasing on December 5th, mark your calendars. That album is about 70% at a minimum all found sounds as far as percussion goes and just everything in there. I've sort of moved away from sampling records some time ago, and this is the method that I prefer to work. So I just wanted to share that with you today to show that even though your samples may not reside on vinyl or reside on anything else, you can still sample into a sampler from a computer or anything. If you look at it in that sense, this computer can be synonymous with a turntable, with a vinyl record in it, with tons of vinyl records in it, all made to your design. Anyway, that is all I wanted to share for today. I will catch you on the next one. In the meantime, please do take care of yourself. Peace.